the word says, all things are possible for the one who believes. Then this man said, Lord, I do believe. Help me to overcome my disbelief. What humility. But you first make your stand. You say, yes, like this. Because if you are going to fight your mind, you are not winning. Don't get into a street fight with your mind if you are not winning. Overcome it. With the same way of fighting it. You are the weakness of it.
What did he just say? Don't get in a street fight with your mind because you won't win. Who is the mind? The mind represents the body. The mind represents the banker attorneys. A street fight represents being pulled over by a cop. He said, don't get in a street fight with the mind or the cops because you will not win. See, it's all perception, brothers, when you look into the root of what this yogi's actually getting to. Whether he knows it or not, I have a feeling he probably does know. He knows how to use the language to be able to make a point without giving all the clues away to cause a riot and rock the ship in society because he has a bunch of devotees. Now, it's a little different for us that are free agents. We can do whatever the fuck we want. We don't desire to have devotees following us. Right? We just put shit out there and each man individually networks and collects the information as he comes across the video and he puts the pieces of the puzzle together. See what I'm saying? That's what you call not carrying a banner. When you start carrying a banner, you get devotees. When I use the word devotees, I'm saying followers. And what happens when you have a bunch of followers? An organization happens, and if the followers all of a sudden misinterpret what the leader says, and all of a sudden all shit breaks loose and you have a big giant riot in the city. So don't strive to have followers, brother. Keep it on the low down, carry no banner, and just be and share truth.
It's inside.
Put that on the records and smoke that one in your bowls, brother. Double ball sack on that violin. The cello.